Okay, morning to all of you. In today's tutorial, we'll see some problems with regards to 8255, 8254 timer and 8259A PIC. So the first problem is write a control word to configure port A as input port in mode 0 and port B in mode 1 as output port for 8255. Right, so port A is to be configured as input in mode 0 and port B as output for mode 1. So we know how the control word looks like, right? It's an 8-bit and a control word. So the first, the most significant bit D7 is going to be 1 because it is input output mode. If it is 0, it is BSR, that is bit set reset, that is only for port C, right? So this is an input output mode, so that is why D7 is to be put as 1. After that, the next two bits, that is D6 and D5, they indicate the mode of operation of port A. Since port A is to be configured as mode 0, so that becomes 00. D4 stands for whether port C is up, that the upper 4 bits of port C, whether it is an input or output. So in this case, is nothing is specified about port C. So we just take it default as 0. Right, so port we neglect that. So now D2, which is for port B mode of operation. So port B, it is specified in the question, it is to be mode 1, so we put 1. D1 is going to be whether port B is an output or an input. 0 stands for output, so here it is specified as an output. So that becomes as 0, and then the final one is again with regards to lower bits of port and lower nibble of port C. Since we are not using port C, we put a default 0. So this is how the control word looks like. So in hexadecimal, if you see, this is 94H, right? Okay, so this is the how we write the control word once the conditions are given for 8255. The next one is the other way around, in which an control word is given, we need to write what are those conditions. So again, we do the reverse thing. Since it is 1 here, it indicates input output mode. It is 10, next D6 and D5 is 10. That means port A is in mode 2. 10 stands for 2, right? So that is why it is mode 2 operation. Then it is 0, that means port A is output port. Then D3 is 1, that means port C is input. D2 is 1, that means port B is 1, because for, if you see mode 2 for port A, there are 2 bits for mode, because mode A can port A can work in 0, mode 0, mode 1 and mode 2, whereas port B can work only in mode 0 and mode 1. That is only 1 bit is sufficient for it. So D2 stands for the mode of operation of port B, which is mode 1 out here. 0, that indicates port B is output port, and last one equal to 1, which means a port C lower, which is the lower portion of the port C, is an input port. So these are the conditions which we can derive seeing the control word. Okay. Now coming to the third problem. Now it says write an 8086 assembly language program to read an ASCII character from a keyboard via port A. So port A is going to be an input port which is going to read this ASCII characters. Okay, so it could be mode 0 also, because it is a simple read operation. And there is no need of any handshaking there, so we can have it as mode 0. Then it also says it has to read, there is a condition given, when port C pin number 4, that is pin number 4 is strobed low. That means you have to keep reading information from pin number 4 of port C. Only when it is going low, we need to read it. So that is the condition for reading the data from port A. So we need to read data from pin number 4 of port C, and then as and when it goes low, we have to read the data from the port A. A base address is given as 20H. Okay, so now once base address is given as 20H, so we know 20H indicates port A, 22 will indicate port B, and 24 will indicate port C. That we know it the address in 8255 keeps increasing by 2 bits because A1 line from 8086 is connected to A0 line of 8255, right? So that is the reason this increases by 2. So and the port C is not, no, port B is not used, so that is why 22 is not figuring out here. So port A, port C, and the control register will have an address of 26H. Okay, now once we have done that, now we need to first program it for the, we have to program the 8255 by putting the control word into the control register, right? So what's the control word going to be here? Such it's an input output mode, so it is going to the first most significant bit is going to be 1, then port A mode 0, so 0 0, port A is input, that is why it is 1, port C upper is going to be again an input, that is why, because P7 we need to read P7, right? Input from port C, that is 1, and then port B we are not using, so we put it 0, and the port C lower also we are not going to read it, so we are going to put it as 0. So this control word comes to be 98H, right? So now we are going to push this 98H, we are going to write this 98H into the control register. So we have moved this into AL register and then out control AL. So now the 8255 has been programmed as per our requirement. So, okay, once it is programmed, then we need to read port C, okay, whether it is going low or no. So you have in port C, right? So now you are going to check whether the P4 bit is 0 or not, right? So for that we have an instruction known as test, which we have learnt earlier also, sorry, so which we have learnt earlier, so which is test AL 10H. Okay, 10H is 001 and this is the one, right? So once we do this, what does test do? That's an AND operation. So we have read port C. Now the P4 is whether it is low or not, that we can test using this test command, right? It does an logical AND, bitwise logical AND. This test command does an bitwise logical AND. So if this is 0, when we read, if the P4 is 0, the entire thing will become 0. Otherwise, it will be 1, right? So jump not Z. If it is not 0, you go back again here to read 1. Again, you keep taking input from port C. So this loop will continue as long as the port C is not 0. Okay, the moment port C becomes 0, so this 10H, so when you do an AND operation with this, you will get a 0 here and it will come out of the loop, and then in port A, so that now the data which is available in port A will be read into the AL register and we end the program. So this is how this program is to be written. Now the next problem is identified the port address of the control register. This is an count problem related with 8254. We need to find the control register, port address of the control register. So this configuration connection with respect to 8086 is given here in the figure. Now if you see here, in the timer, unlike in the 8255 and 8259, where A0 is always connected to A1 from 8286, in timer you can always connect A0 from 8086 to A0 and A1, because it is, see, in those cases, there might be a requirement of like if you have in this case, you might want to connect two 8255s as even and odd bank, and that is the reason you leave aside 80, like we studied the memory banking. Okay, a similar thing can be done out here with 8255 also. That is the reason we use A1 here to 8255, and we use A0 for a chip select. Okay, so that chip that can be used to make one even bank and odd bank, and we can fetch 16-bit data also if required by using the BHE and A0 and chip select. So if you remember what we studied in the memory banking class, so similar things can be done in 8255. That is the reason we always give A1 to A0, and these address lines they move on a 20, 22, 24, and 26. Whereas in A254, that's not the case. You can always give A0 and A1 because this is the timer. We are not going to fetch any 16-bit data, but we are, in fact, this is a 16-bit register, but we give it by two consecutive commands. Okay, we have read that we have studied that in the theory. Okay, now that is why A0, A1 is given out here like this. Right, and if you see A15 is decoded and used as an chip select. So now to find out the address, now A15 has to be 1, and then A0, this is directly given an A0 out here. So this will be the address lines now here. So we are taking A14 to A1 to A2, we are all assuming it to be zeros out here, right? So the address starts from 8001 for counter 1, 8002 for counter 2, and 8003 for control register. So these are going to be the address, the four addresses which is corresponding to the counter. Once having done that, now we have to the question says, write a subroutine to initialize the counter in mode counter 2 in mode 0 and put a count of 50,000. Okay, and also the subroutine should include reading counts on fly when the count reaches 0. So whenever the count is 0, you should be able to read whatever is there in the counter also. So that also needs to be done. So now if you see, so we first we need to initialize this counter. Okay, so the control word would be 10, which stands for counter 0, and we need to put this 50,000 into this counter, right? So 50,000 means hexadecimal is C350, right? So now for C350 you require an 2 bytes of information. So this is going to be 11. So this stands for number of bytes, right? 11 means both the MSB and the LSB requires to be loaded. So this count, we are now programming it for the counter to mode 0 operation. It says control word to initialize counter 2 in mode 0. So this is going to be 00. Now count in binary. So the control word will become B0H, right? And also we need to read the counter 2 in fly mode. That's when the counter is still running, we need to keep checking what is the value of the counter. So that is why we activate this latch. Okay, so counter 2, so the control word will be counter 2. 10 stands for counter 2. Counter latch command, so whenever we want to activate the counter latch, we put 00, and these are the don't cares. So 10 stands, so 10 and then 00 and then these zeros, this means counter 2 has been enabled for counter latch operation. So this comes to be 80H. So these are the two control words which we need to use. So what the program goes like this. So first counter 2, the address will be 8002, and then the control word, the equation will be the address will be 80003, right? So first we are going to move B0 into AL. And then B0, that is the control word that we just learned, the control word for programming counter 2 for mode 0 operation. So we are going to this is going to be the address for the control register, and then we first move this control word for setting the mode of operation of the counter to we are going to move that. Okay, and then we need to move the count which is required, which is for the so we move this 50 into AL, and then we are moving out to the control 2 out here, right? Okay, 50 also stands for example, okay, AL is 50H. First we are moving B0, and then counter 2. So into the counter 2 we need to move. This is the data which is corresponding to 50,000 C3 50. So first the LSB is 50 and then MSB is C3. So we are going to move 50 AH into the counter 2 and then C3 again into the counter 2. So what we have done till here is we have first set for the mode of operation of counter 2 and then we have loaded these data, the count value that is 50 and C3 into the counter 2. So it is the same counter both, but since you have LSB is first pumped in and then the MSB is pushed out here. Okay, once having done that, then you move and then you have to initiate the flyback read, right? So 80 we have seen here, 80 is the command latch control word. So we are going to put 80H into the AL and then we are going into the move it into the counter. Now what we are, now we are able to continuously latch the data of the counter. Now we need to read the counter. So we are going to read it into the AL register. Okay, the first control word and then move it into DL because the counter is a 16-bit counter. So we have to check whether it is 0 or not. So first in the LSB would come into the AL. Now that LSB byte, okay, so that LSB byte is now moved to the DL register. Again you write one more in command from counter 2. Now the MSB byte from again the AL register, from the counter 2 comes into the AL register. Then we do an OR operation. Okay, OR operation of AL and DL. Now if you see, now this is a 16-bit data we are doing an AND operation. So if it is 0, then you come out of the loop. If it is not 0, you again read the counter value. So this is a loop. It will continuously keep running till the counter is 0. Once it is 0, it will come out of the loop. So this is how we write a program for this. The next problem is the clock frequency. Okay, now the clock frequency is given as 2 MHz. Okay, so from here onwards I'll just put you Gandhi also into the loop. The problem goes like this. We need to program an 8254 so that we are programming an 8254. We have written a subroutine so that when the count reaches 0, it should return to the main program. So that we have done that. Now the next part of the program is write a program to display seconds by calling the subroutines as many times as possible, right? So we need to display seconds out here. So if you see, the clock frequency is given as 2 MHz. So that corresponds to 5 into 10 to the power of minus 7 seconds. Okay, that is the time which time taken for each clock, for each clock. Now we have loaded 50,000 into the counter. So when the counter starts from 50,000 and it comes to 0, it is going to take 25 milliseconds, right? 50,000 into 5 into 10. So 25 milliseconds is the time taken for the clock, for this program to run, for this subroutine to run. Okay, what is this subroutine? It is written, okay, if I go back here, that you are going to load the counter with 50,000 and it has to come to 0. So once you load 50,000 and it will take 50,000 clock cycles for it to come to 0, right? And each clock cycle is 5 into 10 to the power. So 25 milliseconds is the time taken for that subroutine to come to 0. Now, but we require 1 second to be displayed. Okay, every 1 second, the output display should change to 1, 2, 3, 4. So how many times this subroutine needs to be run? So 1 second divided by 25 milliseconds, that is 40 times this subroutine needs to repeat itself, okay, which comes out to be 28H. Okay, so this is 28H. So what we are going to do is move BL, initializing BL with 00, move, we are going to put the counter value of 28H into the CL register and call for the subroutine. Okay, what is this subroutine? This subroutine is nothing but it is going to put 50,000 into the register and slowly decrement it till 0 and come out of the loop. So and that has to happen 28 times, right? So we are putting call counter, decrease CL, jump if not, so it will again call for. So till CL becomes 20, 0 0, so this will keep repeating. That means this, that original subroutine which we have written, that is going to be executed 28 times. Okay, once it gets 28 times, that means the time taken will be 1 second out then. Then you move ALBL. Okay, BL is 0 0, so AL also becomes 0 out here. Then we are going to move add 1, so AL becomes 1. Then we are doing a decimal adjust and out 25H. So this is the port address where this data requires to be displayed. So now at the output, the display will be 1. Now again, we are putting that 1 into BL also and jump to second. So you go to second out here, again initialize the counter to 28H and again run it. Okay, now it will again run for 1 more second. Once it's and it will come out of the loop after 1 second. So once it comes out of the loop after 1 second, you are adding 1 to AL. So once you add AL, AL becomes now 2. Now it, we are going to display 2 on the output port and again jump back to the original program. So this will keep happening. So you at the output, you will have another display changing from 1, 2, 3, 4 and like that at an interval of 1 second. Okay. So now the last, the fifth problem is like this. Write an instruction to generate a pulse with 50 microsecond later from the counter 0, right? So we have to get a pulse every 50 microsecond from counter 0. So the counter is 0 out here. So now if you see 50 microseconds, so the clock frequency is 2 megahertz. So 2 megahertz corresponds to 1/2 megahertz is the clock period. And then pulse time is given as 50. So you have to divide 50 divided by 5 into 10 to the power of minus 7, which is the time period. So you get 100, which is 64H, hexadecimal 64H. So we need to, now if you have to have a pulse at every 50 microseconds, that means it is a mode 2 operation, right? So first we have to have a control word. So counter 0, so 0 0. Okay, and then you have to, so this is going to be 0 1, because we just have to load a count of 64. So this is only LSB, this is only 1 byte of data available. So we just have to put here. Okay, so this becomes MSB becomes 0, LSB becomes 64, and mode 2, so 0 1 0. So this is the control word format, right? So 0 1 0, count in binary. So the control word is 14H. Is it clear, Gandhi?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so this is the control word. Now, if you see, counter 0 will have an address 000H control word is going to be 8003, right? So here, if you see, it is not increasing by 2, okay? Counter 1 will be 1, counter 2 will be 8002, okay? That is because initially in the problem definition, if I see which you missed out, so it is like A1 is connected to A1 and A0 is connected to A0 from the 8086 size side, right? So that is why the address is the consecutive numbers instead of leaving us at 1. So this address is counter corresponds to 8003, right? So first we move this control word 14H into the control register and out control, move it into AL and then out AL to control register. Okay, and then we need to load this count 64 into AL. So 64 into AL, which is the count which we need to put into the counter 0, and out counter 0 AL. Okay, so this is how. And now the last problem is show that 8255 interfacing connections with 80 with address starting with 074X. Write an ALP to initialize 8259. It is a single level, single, it is not cascaded mode, level triggered, non-buffered, on specially fully nested mode. Okay. Then set 8255 to operate in IR6. The IR6 requires to be, the interrupt 6 requires to be masked, and a specific EOI mode. So all these conditions for programming 8259 is given. So accordingly, we need to write a program, right? This is like you have this decoder, address decoder, which like we have done for For IO and memory mapping. So this is something very similar. So we have, so whenever this address is placed, this particular chip select line has to go high. So we'll not discuss this, you are well aware of how it is done, right? So we'll just see about how to program this 8259 out here, right? So the first is ICW1. So the format of the ICW1 is given out here. So if you see the first, this is A0 bit, right? So this is A0 has to be 0 for ICW1. Okay, and then these are the 7 and 8 bits out here. So here if you see the first 3 for ICWs don't care for 8086, so we put 000, and this is also 1, so this is also 1, it is fixed. Okay, so that also, so this is 0001 for ICW1, these 4 bits are fixed initially only, so we write 0001 out here. And this is level triggered, since it's written in the question, it is level triggered, so this becomes 1. Okay, so this is 1. And then this is also 1 for 8086. This bit is also 1. This is single, it is not a cascode mode, so where we have only a single 8259 here, so this becomes 1 out here. And this is also going to be 1 for ICW for 8086, because ICW4 is mandatory for 8086, so this is also going to be 1 out here. So if you see, for ICW1 there are only 2 variables which we need to send. These are all, these 3, 0 and 1, this is fixed. This one is also fixed, and this is also fixed. Only whether if this is going to be 1 if it is level triggered, and this is, if it is in a single mode, it is going to be 1. If it is cascaded, this is going to be 0, and if it is edge triggered, this is going to be 0. Since in this particular case it is level triggered and single, this is 1 1. So ICW1, from this we can see it is 1F. Okay, so this is how ICW1. Now coming to ICW2. So it says the vector, ICW2 stands for, we are going to give the vector address. And the first bit out here, this is the address line bit, which has to be 1 for ICW. This is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. The address bit is not shown here. So in ICW2, if you see, it is the vector address of IR1 is given as 81. But we have to feed the address, IR address for IR0, which will become 80, right? So this is going to be 80H. This is the vector address which we need to feed next, ICW2, which is 80H. Okay, so in the question, if it is written 81, 82, 83 for IR2 or IR3, we have to compute what will be the value for IR0. So they are all will be in a sequence only. So for IR0, it will be 80. So that is going to be ICW2 out here. Right now, since it is in cascode mode, it is in a single mode of operation, ICW3 is not applicable out here, so we straight away come to ICW4 out here. Right, in ICW4, these three are again 0 for 8086, so we don't have to do anything. This is 1 for specially fully nested mask. Okay, so that is, it is already written, it is specially fully nested mode, so this is going to be 1 here. And this is going to be non-buffered mode, because we are not using master or slave operation, so this is going to be a 00. It is given in the question also, non-buffered, so this becomes 00. And then this is normal EOI mode, so that is also given in the question, it is an a normal EOI mode. And then this is going to be 1 for 8086. So the now ICW4 will become 11H. Okay, so we have to find, similarly the last one is going to be the OCW1, right? In this it says ki we need to, the question says you need to mask IR6, right? So is it the IR6? Okay, the input IR6 requires to be masked. So OCW1 is a masking data control word, right? So if you see D6, okay, that has been masked with 1 out here, right? Since the question says you have to mark with this. I think there is an this has to be 0, right? Okay, D4, so this has to be 0. So if you mask only D6, it will be 40H. Okay, this is correct, but this one is wrong out here, so you need to mask D6. So OCW will be 0 here. Now when we write a program, it would go like this. First ICW1, So the first ICW one is, and we have programmed it as AF. Okay, we have seen that ICW one is AF, that we move it into AL register, and then 0740. So because that is the port address which has been given, so for 0740, so we are moving ICW one. Then ICW then the second data which is 040, we are moving into the DX register, and then out DXAL. So now we have sent the ICW1. Okay, now for ICW2, the address will be changed to 0442, because the first bit, if you go to ICW2 out here, ICW2 here. Okay, this is 0 for ICW1, this A0 bit. For ICW2, this has to be 1 out here. So, which is not shown here, that A0 bit, which is coming from 8086, that is not shown here. That has to be 1. So, and then it is ATH, right? So, now, so the address becomes 0742, that we are moving into DX register. And then AT, we are going to move it into the AL. And then we are sending that data into the output port, which is an indicated by the DX register. So now ICW2 has been sent to the 8259. Now the next one is to send an ICW3 is not there, ICW4. So now again ICW4 we got as 11. So that 11 we are going to move into AL, and then the address corresponding is again 0742, because ICW4 also A0 bit starts with 1 out there. If I go back to ICW4 out here, here it is 1. So if it is 1 here, the address is going to be 0472. So now and then we move it into the DX register. 72 we have moved it into the DX register, and then we are moving the required data, that ICW4 data, into the AL register, and we are using an out command to send the data to 0472. Okay, and the last one is OCW. Now if I go to OCW here, again this is an 1 out here, so I don't have to reload DX, so it is already set to 0472. So I just move the OCW data into the AL register, and I use an out command, right? So with this we have programmed ICW1, ICW2, ICW4 and OCW1 to the chip. Okay, so this is how we write a program for that. Okay, so that's all for today.